Amen, amen. I hope you're enjoying Yolanda Adams. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Amen. We're back here again on the Circle of Lord Prayer Partners radio show on this wonderful evening, Tuesday, at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. They go live each and every week. We give God glory and honor for the woman of God. Amen. Your radio host tonight, Evangelist Linda Ellis.
Please, in the name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, amen. Thank you, Pastor Ackridge and the TMA radio show. It is an honor to be back tonight again with you all. Amen, and I will not be before you long, but I'm here on behalf of the Circle of Prayer Partners Ministry, and I am again Linda Ellis, the overseer of the group. You can find us on Circle of Prayer Partners page, amen, on Facebook, and we are on the conference call and TMA radio station every Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, amen. And I was on, blessed to be on a Facebook Live conference today with Dr. J. Lemuel Spitz, praise God, and he has a teaching of wisdom. He has great wisdom God has blessed him with, and he shares it with the people of God, and he said the Lord says to him that February is the month of walking in newness of life. So many of us fasted the week of January. We started off our year with fasting and prayer, seeking change, amen, and the revival, the Circle of Love Prayer Partners revival was surrender, submit, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed. Praise God, amen. And we had the great men and women of God preaching on how to be transformed, amen. And so Dr. Lemuel gave us some points, some dynamics about how to walk in our newness, amen. And he talked about the mind. First of all, it has to be renewed. You have to have a made-up mind to be committed to walk in the newness. And you have to speak what you are, you have to say, you know, what you want to call those things that are not as if they are. That's what the Bible tells you. And you got to have action. You just can't see it and wish it to come. Amen. Too many of us have that, procrastinated, and waited. The Bible says, seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and the door shall be opened. And many of us, for whatever reason, some out of fear, some out of slothfulness or laziness or whatever the reason has been, we have failed to get up. And I'm one of those that have not sought after the blessing. It's hard. We make excuses, and I'm getting ahead of myself, at least ahead of Dr. Lemuel. His first point was you have to develop direction of your newness. You have to decide which way you want to go. You have to make a concrete decision to walk in newness. When you do that, you will dedicate yourself, commit to the new way. You will settle in that decision that you won't go back to the old ways. Amen. Praise God. We remember the Israelites. It became difficult, and they wanted to go back to Egypt. They said it was better back there. You know, we at least had water and had more comfortable things there than out here in this hot desert without the food and the water that we desire. But we know that God came through, and he did supply. So you got to decide, what is it I want to accomplish in 2019? And make a decision to walk in the newness, forgetting those things which are behind us. There's no need to cry over spilled milk. There's no need to talk about the coulda, woulda, shoulda. Some of us stay stuck in our past. Praise the Lord. And then we cry and say, other people hold us hostage, but sometimes we are our own worst enemy. We ourselves hold ourselves back, amen, in our past. And we want new things, but we must make a decision to let go of the old. We must be exhausted, tired, and very tired of the old way not working. Amen. If it didn't work in the last 5 years, then it's not going to work in 2019, Linda. It's time to let go and let God. If your way didn't work, it's time to seek the ways of the Lord. It's time not to lean to your own understanding, but acknowledge Him and ask Him for direction for the ministry, for your family as head of the household, or your business, your career, whatever it is that you're seeking newness in, to walk in new directions. Praise the Lord. Amen. I've heard so many testimonies of how even professional ball players, I remember this young man came to our church and spoke on a youth day program, and he was an NFL player, got drafted and started out. But he, in the first game or two, his knee became fractured or ruptured or whatever. He messed his knee up. So that meant he could no longer play. But all the time that he had spent, him and his father, getting up before dawn and practicing, and he had labored in it, praise God. And that was what he wanted to be. He thought he was going to be a professional football player. But long story short, God had another plan. And now he is the head of the district of, a whole lot of young people, where he go out and he open doors for other young people to go out into their careers and to get training and to give his testimony. And, I remember last week, this gentleman, I don't know who he is. I never seen him post anything. But he posted on Circle of Love Prayer Partners. And it really disturbed me. But anyway, he said, God hasn't done anything for him. And he don't know why he keeps serving them, and he pray for other people and they get blessed, and he has a business. And he told about his plight of, how he was failing in his business, not being as prosperous or successful. And he went on. And so I sat there and I prayed, and it disturbed me. But I don't know if you read the post or not. The Lord, Holy Spirit, gave me something simple to say to him. And that was, first of all, you are blessed and highly favored, and you can't say that God didn't do anything for you, because he woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. He gave you a chance. And this is part of what I said, but I just feel the Spirit of God upon me, because he gave us eyesight. He gave us hearing. He gave us the ability to put on our clothes. He gave some jobs, and praise the Lord, amen, careers, and some have their own business, entrepreneurs, and whatever. You get up every day, and a lot of these things we take for granted. But I do remember I told him, you weren't in jail, you weren't in hell, you weren't in the crazy house, and you were able to put on your own clothes. So that right there, God blessed you tremendously. And then I thought about the song. Writer said, if God don't never do anything else for us, when he sent his only begotten son, John 3:16, Lord have mercy, Jesus, we were on our way to hell because of Adam and Eve in the garden. We were born in sin and shaped into iniquity. So when he sent his son and Jesus laid his life down for us, he redeemed us. He paid a price that we could not pay. If you say that and demand on the Facebook, on our platform's page, he says, I am a 100% Christian. Those were his words, not mine. So I told him, if God don't do anything else for you, when he gave you his son Jesus in your stead, he's done enough. But when it comes to your business, if you Maybe if you're not prospering, maybe you need to consult him. Maybe you're in the wrong business. Maybe God has another plan for you. So you need to seek him and say, Lord, is this what you want for me? Because there is nothing too hard for God. And God said he'll give you anything you ask. He said he'll prosper you as your soul prospers. There's so many scriptures where God will bless his people. So, you know, that's what made me question, well, maybe he's in the wrong business. But nevertheless, seek first the kingdom of heaven, and all these other things will be added. So, you know, I just say, praise the Lord, amen. We have to consult God. Amen. So the second thing he said, never allow space for an exception. We're talking about walking in the newness of life. And this is the teaching, my take on what Dr. Linwood Spence talked today. Amen. He said, when you want to walk in newness of life, you never allow space for an exception. Amen. If you decided that you are going to lose weight, Linda, and sweets is your thing, and today you fasted from the sweets, or you just abstained from the sweets, well, tomorrow, I can't say make an exception. And so with just this one, because see, truthfully, Linda just can't eat that one cookie. Because if you're sitting there calling my name and I go back and eat two or three, you know. So you never allow a space for exception, because if you allow that one time, you may find yourself off in the realm of you can't get back. You just gone astray. You know, you just lost that. But, you know, that's why a lot of people make these New Year's resolutions and they say before the 22nd of January, they've gotten off course and gone back to the old routine. So Dr. Spirit said, never allow space for the exception. Get rid of your excuses. Don't abandon the new process, not one time. Don't rationalize and allow the old to come back. If you told that joker goodbye, if he didn't help you last year, if he caused you heartache, if you know he's not going to change, why are you going to let him come back again this year? Over and over, the same thing, especially if the Lord has told you to get rid of him. And you know he's no good for you or her. That relationship, it could be just a friendship. It could be a family member that, you know, they have things when you do drugs and alcohol, they call triggers. And some people are triggers. As long as you don't get around them, you can do good and not think about it. But as soon as you get with JoJo or my, then you off into drinking or clubbing or something you don't have in the business. So if you know that you want to walk in the newness of life, then you got to refrain. You got to stick to your guns and say no. Praise the Lord. Amen. Number three is tell others that are important to you that you are practicing new behavior. Well, I heard I'm going to say that, but you know, everybody's not for you that's important to you. You love family, but some of them don't want to see you succeed. And the minute you tell them they stop trying to, I'm going to quit smoking, here they come around you blowing smoke in your face or buying you a pack of cigarettes. Or you say, I'm going to lose weight. And, you know, they want to take you out when they ever been taking you out to Applebee's or whatever. So sometimes you have to cut those people off. Amen. Empty out old relationships that don't help produce new behavior. Praise the Lord. Number four is visualize. When you're trying to walk in newness, you have to see yourself in the new life. You know how they said you have the visual boards on your refrigerator or somewhere in the house? And you, if you want that car, you put it up where you can see yourself in it. You see that car, you see your business or whatever. You see it. Before you see yourself as the head of that company. You see your company without, instead of two employees with 10 employees or that new house or whatever, visualize it, see it. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Number five, Dr. Spence, is create an affirmation. Repeating scriptures or positive words, confirming your actions. Create a statement that talks to you. And you get up every morning or at night or whatever you say, especially in the morning. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. Whatever it is, you find a scripture, God's promises, or even maybe created words that don't have to be scripture that will encourage you, will push you, praise God, to walk into the newness. Call those things, as the Bible says, that are not, as if they were already. Praise God. Amen. Affirmations empower us, and they keep us on the path of our new walk. Number six is be persistent. You must not quit, no matter how challenging. You know, we're going to have difficult days. Some days are easier than others. Praise God. You must be persistent. And don't allow others' response to discourage you to quit. I've been guilty of that. I've, you know, told somebody, oh, I'm going to lose weight. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. And their response was negative, or they didn't respond the way I wanted them to or thought they should, or they weren't with me or whatever, and I just didn't follow through. Amen. I'm like, okay, you know, and I allowed what they thought or how they reacted to govern my response, and that was not good at all. Amen. Number seven, the last one, is reward yourself. When you accomplish your goals, or when you, or even though you may not have accomplished the total goal, but when you see yourself headed in the right direction, even if it's like, again, losing weight, if you lost 5 pounds, you know, or you not, your diet has changed, when you used to be a sweet person, when you ate all junk food and or whatever, carbs, whatever, if you've had a successful week, no, don't reward yourself to go out and eat a bunch of junk, but do something to celebrate you. Don't wait for others to pat you on the back, because you might not get it. Amen, amen. And so he shared that with us on Facebook Live, and his name is, that was the first time I ever really listened to him, but he has a lot of wisdom, and I will be listening again, Dr. J. Lemuel Spence, and he is on our Circle of Prayer Partners page, the whole message that you can go back and hear it for yourself, take notes, and maybe get something I didn't speak on. Amen. Praise God. And so I wanted to share it to you, with you, for walking in the newness in 2019. And at this time, amen, I'm going to ask Pastor Nino to close us out. Praise God. Well, let me say this. I thank you for listening to the Circle of Prayer Partners radio show. And I pray that you either join us live with the TMA radio show, or either call into the conference line every Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And at this time, I'm going to turn it over to Pastor Nino Akers to close us out with a prayer.
Heavenly Father, we just come saying thank you for another moment on this Circle of Love Prayer Partners radio show. We thank you, God, for the host tonight, sharing a few points on how we can change. God, allow us to change through you and your spirit as you continue to lead us. God, direct our feet, direct our path. Oh, God, clear up our understanding, that we will clear, that we have direct understanding on which way to go and which way to turn, when to let go and when to endure. God, continue to be with us and guide us and lead us. us, oh God. We thank you now for this radio broadcast. We thank you for all this listeners that's tuned in tonight. Oh God, we ask now, God, if there's anything that we said or done, God, that displeased you, forgive us now, oh God, in creating us a clean heart. Renew our mind to a right spirit. Father, as we continue this broadcast, we love you, we adore you, and we thank you for the many that continue to tune in. We pray for somebody that's trying to give up. God, give them strength in the name of Jesus. There's somebody that might be sick on their bed. Father, we ask that healing come forth in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we speak those things into the atmosphere as though they were healing come forth, deliverance come forth. Oh God, their children, oh God, the parents, oh God, they will be saved and set free. We have to believe it, oh God, and God, give us the strength to believe it and the faith to endure. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, amen. Amen, guys. We're going to continue the broadcast and we'll be right back. So stay tuned. Amen. Remember that God is only using you for this battle is not yours. It's the Lord.